So, we're here for round two against a potentially more competitive opponent. Must be, as he won his first round. He or she. Our hand has no gates, no gatekeepers. Two lands, two rocks. It seems fine. It doesn't have white mana, but we can cast Augur Spree and maybe get to that in not that long. And we are on the draw, and one of the beautiful things about Magic is you get to draw a fresh new card every single turn of the game. And that's something we're really going to take advantage of this game, as our opening seven has no castable spells. So the ideal draw in the first two turns are gates. And we got there on one. We do want white mana. If it takes us a while to hit white mana, that's okay. We only have five white sources in our deck. We don't have a whole lot of white cards in general, though. Oh, great. Murmuring Phantasm. We just don't care about that at all. Axebane Guardian is a good draw, because it unlocks our white. I don't know that we want to play it turn three, because I don't necessarily want to expose it to removal. So I think maybe we'll play like a Dimir Kirun first, and then if we hit a fourth land, go Clue Stone into Axebane, and then maybe fuse this a little after. Although, I guess this is, it was not a strong play, right, because it didn't do much. But, maybe this will deter an attack. No, I don't really want to block with it, though. So maybe that was wrong. Oh, well. I don't think it's going to die in blue-green. Anyways, I don't think this was a strong play right then, but it's actually not bad in that deck because it evolves almost everything for only two mana. Obviously, I'm happy to see him use this as just a blocker when we're not going to blitz him in any kind of way. And the Guildgate maybe like made him play it because it's like, oh, we're playing against Rakdos, right? He may play a Gorehouse Chainwalker or something. So that Rakdos Guildgate was an exceptional draw in perhaps several ways. It may have forced his hand on that Murmuring Phantasm. Okay, great. So the Axebane did deter his attack. Fairy Impostor. Oh, he can pick up the Phantasm. Okay, never mind. He's just going to pick it up anyways. But yeah, he missed an attack. I wasn't going to block. Doesn't make sense to risk our pretty essential Axebane Guardian. So here I'm thinking it makes sense for us to play a... Which would we rather have, blue or black? Double blue, double red, black. Okay, play this and play a Centaur Healer just to kind of cement the ground a little bit. He can evolve this. He's got a flyer that's trucking in also. We do have this Augur Spree to take care of something later on. 3, 4, 5, 6. And we're only a turn away from fusing this. Although, it's much better when you know they have something good. So hopefully play something good that we can Augur Spree. Trample evolve. Well, I'd happily trade, given the opportunity. Doesn't offer the trade. That's fine. Figures he's going to keep evolving this. Okay, so here's the game plan. We're going to play a Clue Stone. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 3, 7, 8. We already have 8. We're going to Augur Spree something. Probably this Monitor. End of turn. It could be anything, though. And then we're going to fuse this, targeting him. Hopefully get a better target, but worst case, we'll grab, like, I don't know, one of these or whatever. Maybe we want to kill the Crassus because it's going to represent being bigger. Like, it's going to be pretty big. Could keep growing. And we definitely want it to die. I imagine he's going to play his O5 this turn. Maybe not. The ideal is he plays some, like, crazy creature, like a Fathom Mage or something. Although, we're like somewhat behind on board. We've got a lot of life to work with, but I'd like this game to go... Okay, we'll block the Monitor. We may return that. Scavenge is a long way off for him, and it's going to give us more options when using or not using this Augur Spree. Yeah, that thing. We maybe want to save the Augur Spree just to deal with whatever he's going to target with that, but if he's a million miles away from scavenging this, it just doesn't matter that much. Forced adaptation. Okay. That makes things tricky, because I was thinking we would just for sure Augur Spree this Battering Crassus. But this thing will get bigger than the Battering Crassus and not that long, so I think we're going to kill that one. And hopefully we pull something from his deck that's just huge. And can kind of deal with that. Maze Glider is not a bad draw. But he can make an 0-5 and then tap this. So I think it seems better to just defuse this. Although if we don't hit anything good, it's not very good. Because a 3-3 is not going to do a whole lot against that board. Because it's going to be a 5-4 and not very long. Pretty greedy play. 3, 4, 5, 6. We could just play 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We could just play a Maze Glider. 3, 4, 5, 6. And crack Clue Stone. I think that'll be fine. And represent making Demir Key Rune into a guy as well. When he's stuck on mana, the Hazardous Snare Squad isn't the best because he doesn't have a ton of mana to use. So it's possible we could get a double block on the Crassus, which I would be happy with, actually. Like, if our glider dies, that's fine by me because we're just going to break and entering it right back. That for sure gives us a good target. So we'll see what he does. Given an opportunity, I'll double block even if it means getting quote-unquote blown out by some kind of trick, because we'll just get this back and get the trick out of his hand. See what happens. See what he does. Although he may use his Hazardous Snare Squad to tap our glider. In which case we can crack the Clue Stone. Green Crawl Warrior. Maybe he's just not going to attack because he doesn't want that trade to happen. Oh, he is. Okay. It's interesting that he would tap mana first. Seems like a mistake. So, yeah, we can get the Crassus off the table. And we can just get our Maze Glider right back, most likely. Unless he presents us with something really juicy. He's got decent late game in this and in the monitor, but he's not having a lot of mana, so it's definitely kind of favoring us for a little while. Favoring us to not die, obviously. We're at 19. He doesn't have good attacks. Okay. Or we could just play Risen Sanctuary and return it next turn with flying. That actually seems a little bit better. And the longer we can go without using this, the more options we're going to have as well, I feel. So, let's play our casual draw on 8-8, which has been much better than the 6 Courser's Accord, by the way. Which is a more powerful effect. We can afford one more mana. Train Caracal. Yeah, that's interesting. Subescues are interesting. I went a lot here. I don't know why. Who knows? Alright, well, 1, 2, 3, we're going to fuse this. Maybe he's held up a counterspell, but he only has one card left. And I don't really want to sit here and wait. I'd love to get our thing flying over it. So, let's see what happens. Tap the mana wrong. I should have left up Demir Key Rune in case. We hit Naxxband Guardian from him? No, that doesn't make sense. This is fine, doesn't make a difference. So maybe he's got some kind of a counterspell, which is semi-annoying, but he doesn't have enough power on board. Ooh, okay, we hit Skylasher, Adaptive Snapjaw, Syndic, Fairy Imposter. None of these are as good as Maze Glider, because Maze Glider gives our Risen Sanctuary flying. It's also a 3-5, which is really big. I think the best thing we could have taken from him is this Monitor, just so it's not in his graveyard. Oh, this has haste. I just missed an attack for 3, which is lethal next turn. Whoops. So, this is an effect of this that I keep forgetting grants. So if he survives and wins the game as a result of that, then it's going to feel really bad. But I don't think that's going to be the case. Maybe it will be, though. Who knows? It's not using this. Oh, well, we have this anyways, which is unblockable. So we can still kill him this turn. We're holding the Maze Glider back for defense, guys, obviously. Duh, we knew it was the right play. Alright, well, we got there. Turn 9. We blitzed him out. Again, I just don't really see a reason to sideboard. We don't have a lot of good options. Backlash, Guild Mage, Tower Defense. If we're playing a strict control deck, then maybe. I don't hate the Smelt Ward Guardians. I want to try them out sometime, but this just doesn't seem like the matchup for it. Submit.